बी रेडी फॉर द डिक्टेशन स्टार्ट. व्हाट हैज एक्चुअली ट्रबल्ड अस इज द वेरियंस बिटवीन प्रिसेप्ट एंड प्रैक्टिस इन दिस कंट्री. व्हेन वी डिस्कस फिलॉसफी वी राइज टू हिमालयन हाइट्स एंड व्हेन इट इज ए क्वेश्चन ऑफ पर्सनल लाइफ वी गो टू द एबिस्मल डेप्थ ऑफ द अरेबियन सी. There is so much variance between precept and practice in this country that even if a particular individual might be trying to adhere to the precepts, he also becomes suspect because the general atmosphere is one of suspicion. In that context, sir, I feel that something has got to be done to restore the confidence of the people in the members of parliament, in the members of legislatures, and in the ministers. Now, my friend made a suggestion that after all, we are all answerable to the people in this country, and when representatives come through elections and people vote for them, that is a sure proof of the people's confidence in these elected representatives. I would respectfully differ from my friend on this kind of a diagnosis or analysis of the problem that electorally everything can be solved. The problem of human character, human integrity, human behavior, morality cannot be solved by an electoral process. There have been men in the world who are of great moral stature, men of great character and integrity, but they never won an election. Are we not aware of Shri Rajgopalachari, who was a man of great character and integrity? Nothing can be said against him. He was a man of high moral stature, but he never won an election. He was also defeated in an election. Para. Let us not try to beguile ourselves by saying that by our being electorally established, our character is established, our integrity is established, our moral standard is established. After all, the kind of electoral system that we have in this country itself corrupts the entire political system, the entire politics in this country. How many of us can claim that we limit ourselves to the amount prescribed in the Representation of the People Act when we contest an election? Which member of parliament does not spend above that amount? How many of us file a true return in compliance with the provisions of the Representation of the People Act? Most of the candidates file false returns, and this has been taken as an accepted way of life. Therefore, we should not expect that once it is electorally established that somebody has been elected, he must automatically be deemed to be a man of character, a man of integrity, and so on and so forth. Such a proposition, at least I personally cannot accept it.